people of Montego Bay have long wanted to have their bypass road. This is something that everybody knows they deserve and need. However, the way in which the government is going about it, we disagree with fundamentally. Principle is principle.
The procurement rules of this country are a vital process to protect Jamaican taxpayers from the waste or other misuse of public funds.
The main way in which it can be assured that a big contract like the bypass road achieves value for money and that the pricing of the contract is fair to the Jamaican people is through ensuring a competitive bidding process that sets the price and chooses a contractor.
Jamaica has been building new major roads and highways for a long time now. There is no compelling need for the procurement rules to be waived for this project.
In this instance, the government has decided not to go that route, but to award the contract to one overseas contractor. We have no issue with the contractor. We have an issue with the process that the government has followed. And the difference between this project and other projects that have happened before is that whereas before, the financing to pay for the project has been borrowed from a lender who has said you must use a contractor from our country if you want the financing. In this instance, there's no borrowing. The project is going to be financed out of the budget from the taxes that you and I pay every day in this country. And value for money must be obtained, pursued rigorously in the interests of the Jamaican people.
Without allowing other interested and qualified contractors to bid for the work, provides no transparency and no assurance of Jamaica getting value for taxpayers' money.
The main reason given by the government as to why they don't want to go down the route of a competitive bidding process to select the contractor is they say that this contractor has done preparatory work, planning work, and so on, and it would be unfair to them if it was opened to qualified bidders to bid for the contract. That is not my concern. My concern is fairness to the Jamaican people. Of course, in the interest of fairness, if Jamaica has received value from the contractor's preparatory work and plans, we must pay them a reasonable amount for that. But that is no reason for not having a competitive bidding process that ensures this $30 billion project is priced in the best interest of the Jamaican people. Look at the Cornwall Regional Hospital. St. James is without that hospital functioning properly for years now. Resources are part of the reason why it's taking so long. If this project is not properly and fairly priced, resources will be wasted. And furthermore, the waiver itself is defective. There are some important conditions that the finance minister said are part of this waiver, but those conditions will not apply to subcontractors. And we know in these projects that a lot of the work is subcontracted out. The requirements, for example, of a certain minimum percentage of Jamaican employees, the requirements for the transfer of knowledge and technology to Jamaican workers and training and the use of Jamaican inputs wherever possible. None of those are going to be required of subcontractors. They're only required of the head contractor. That is a loophole in the waiver that the minister has granted, and we objected to it. The government could have withdrawn this waiver and reformulated it so that it was more comprehensive and protected the interests of the Jamaican people, the building industry, and workers. They failed to do so. This is why in Parliament we voted against that waiver. We support the idea of a bypass road, but we know the people of Montego Bay need it desperately. We do not want to be a fly in the ointment, but value for money is important when you're spending the money of taxpayers. Jamaica deserves better.
And that is not being fair to the Jamaican people. In fact, there's a better way to describe it. It is selling out the Jamaican people.